All right, so this is just a quick review of the open book quiz that we did. I hope it helps. All right, so we have the SI unit for distance. Well, an acre, you may not be that familiar with it, but that's basically area, okay? It's the area of land. So when you buy a house someday, you'll buy a house with so many acres. Meter is distance. Or length. Length is just the distance between two points. Kilogram is mass, and centiliter, that root there, liter, this is volume. Okay. All right. So the answer here would be meter, because you're looking for the SI unit for distance. All right. For number two, it says, what is the average speed of a boat that travels 57 kilometers in 3 hours? Well, speed is equal to distance over time. So we're just going to say 57 kilometers divided by 3 hours. Okay. And I know 3 will go, 15 would be 45, 16 would be 48, 17 would be 51, and then so 18 would be 54, and 19 would be 57, okay? So the answer would be 19 kilometers per hour, all right? It's just a matter of dividing. If you don't have a calculator, ask for a calculator. How far will the boat in question 3 travel if it maintains this speed for 5 hours? Well, now instead of looking for speed, we're looking for distance. All right, so we know that the speed is 19 kilometers per hour. We know that time is 5 hours. So we can plug in and we can say 19 kilometers per hour is equal to distance divided by 5 hours. And then it's just a matter of algebraically rearranging this. We'll multiply both sides by 5 and then divide both sides by 19. And we end up with 5 hours is equal. No, I'm sorry, I misspoke. That's what I get for trying to do math in my head. We're just going to multiply both sides by 5 hours, right? And I've lost my cursor. There we go. So we're going to have 19 kilometers per hour times 5 hours equals D. So 5 times 19 would be 15, 45. So it would be like 95 kilometers, okay? Just rearrange the equation. You could also take the old electrician's triangle trick. This works for equations that have three variables. Speed is distance over time. And then what you're going to do is, if I need distance, I'll cover up distance, and distance is equal to speed times time, which is what we did up here, speed times time. And if I need time, that's distance divided by speed. If I need speed, that's distance divided by time. So this is the easy way of figuring out what the equation needs to be. If you use an arrow to represent velocity, what does the head of the arrow show? So velocity is a vector. Vectors have two things. They have magnitude, or size, the size of the measurement, and they have direction. All right, the arrow is going to show you the direction. All right, what does delta V over delta T? So that's change in velocity over change in time. So that's going to be acceleration. What is the following? Which of the following is best definition for deceleration? So if acceleration is positive or an increase in speed, then negative acceleration would be deceleration, okay? Acceleration always involves a change in blank. Well, acceleration is two things. Acceleration, as soon as you see the word, you should think a change in speed or a change in direction. All right, so speed, yes. Direction, yes. And speed and direction is velocity, so you'd say all of the above. Which diagram represents balanced forces? So balanced forces are, I've lost my, balanced forces are in the same direction. No, I'm sorry. They are the same size. Oops. Ah. Running out of room on my tablet here. All right, let's see here. They're the same size or same magnitude, but they're in opposite directions. Okay, so these are the same size. I can tell they're the same size because the arrows are the same length, and they're in opposite directions. So these are balanced. All right, here, this force is much more than this force. I know that because the angle is longer, so these are unbalanced. These are not in opposite directions, nor are they in the same direction. This box is actually going to be moving downward and to the left, so it's going to be moving something. I can't draw a straight line. It's going to be moving something like that as the result of these two forces. This one is going to move to the left. This one will not move at all. And D, both of these forces are in the same direction. There are different sizes, but they're going to add together and move the box towards the right. Okay. So the question is balanced forces, so you would have picked A. Which pair of forces in question one will cause the object to move to the right? Well, we said that was number D because the forces are to the right and they are in the same direction, so they add together. Which type of friction do you use when you put on the brakes to stop a brake? What type of friction do you use? All right, so you're moving, so it's probably not static friction. This is not a thing. There's rolling friction and sliding friction left. There's no wheels in the brake of your bike. It's just a pad that presses against the rim of the tire. So I feel the best answer here would be sliding friction. All right. Now the tires themselves, between the tire and the road, that's rolling friction. But the brakes would be sliding friction. That's true of the brakes on your car too. Why does engine oil help prevent an engine from overheating? It reduces friction between the moving parts. So the answer here would be B. Oops. So the answer is B. All right. You would weigh less on the moon than on Earth because, well, gravity, the main factor in gravity, in determining gravity, there's two. There's the mass and the distance between. Okay, we are very close to the Earth, so we feel the Earth's gravity. If we went way up into space on the space shuttle, we would not really feel the gravity of the Earth. It would still be there, we just wouldn't feel it because we're too far away from the Earth. On the other hand, I exert gravity. My pencil exerts gravity, but there's so little mass, we don't feel that mass, that gravity. All right. So you would have less mass on the moon. No, your mass doesn't change. Your weight changes. Weight is the force of gravity. So if you didn't know that, you might want to write it down. Weight is the force of gravity. So gravity changes depending on what planet you're on. Your mass stays the same. All right? The moon has weaker gravity than the Earth. This is true. The moon is about 1/6 the gravity of Earth, and so it exerts 1/6 of the gravity. Let's see here. The moon has a thinner atmosphere. That has nothing to do with gravity. You could have a planet with no atmosphere at all, and it would still have gravity. Okay. Two of the above, no, because we eliminated two of them, and so the answer would have to be B. Albert Einstein was the first person to show that gravity is... So gravity and his, or Einstein and his theory of relativity was like, hey, when we got something that's super massive, like a planet, it curves space-time. And so this well in the space-time, that's what things orbit around, is they're going around. It's kind of like that thing you see at the mall where you put your quarter in and it goes around and around and around and around and around. Okay, that's kind of what happens. Not exactly, but kind of. Examples of objects that make use of elastic force. Hair scrunchies, yes. Pogo sticks, yes, they have a spring. Trampolines, yes, they also have a spring. So the best answer would be all of the above. All right, hope this helps. And if you need a redo, then we'll schedule a redo next week. All right, have a good day and stay curious.